name is Ryan Waterman. Today, we're going to be doing a training sample video for the strength and conditioning certification exam for the ISSA. Here with me today are two collegiate baseball players. Here we have Chris and Dave. They're both pitchers, right-handed. Dave will be going over the plyometric exercises in a minute after our warm-up. We'll be going back indoors, going through our plyos, then we'll come back out to the track and do the rest of our workout. Chris will help out with the rest of the workout. Each of them are going to be switching off each exercise. Unfortunately, you won't get to see that on video. We're just going to do one set of each exercise as a sample. All right, let's get started. Okay, today's warm-up for this workout is going to consist of a 5-minute jog around the track, followed by Dave doing a minute of skipping. Well, Chris does that same minute of lunges using a sandbag. Once that minute's up, they're easy to go. About 50 meters of high knees, then skipping. Then they're going to do shuffles, okay? 25 one way, 25 the other, karaoke. After that, we're gonna do conditioning ropes, just kinda get the whole body good and warmed up. Then we're gonna head back into that gym and get our plyometrics done. I bring it in. So many times it happens too fast. Okay, let's start skipping. Okay, Chris, and turn it back. Seconds and then you switch and switch. Dave grabs the bag. There we go. It's easy if you grab it from the sides, Dave. Turn it back. Okay, we're gonna start with our high knees on the way there. Okay, skip it back. Okay, shuffle facing away halfway, then turn around at halfway point. Stay low, Dave. Okay, karaoke back. Perfect. Last part of our warm-up, get the whole body going. We're gonna use these conditioning ropes. Now, how the athletes are going to do it. They're going to do 20 seconds on, 20 seconds off for each movement. Each movement they're going to do twice, total of three movements. Okay, so six working sets. Jay will go first for 20 seconds. Then during his rest, Chris is going to go in for 20 seconds. Then they'll recover again, repeat. After that, they're going to switch the motion. First motion will be just up and down, the position, hip width, butt back, hips tilted forward, chest out, athletic position. They're not to move their feet at all. Okay. Second motion will be side waves. Okay, for 20 seconds. Third motion. Both at once. I'll tell you when. 3, 2, 1, go. Full power. Ten seconds. And switch. And go. Ten seconds. And switch. And go. Breathe. 10 seconds. 5 seconds. Keep it up. Keep going, keep going, keep going, keep going. And switch. And go. Every single minute you spend trying to hold on to it, cause you may never get it again. So while you're in it, try to get as much shit as you can. And when you run it over, just admit when it's in its end. Cause I'm at the 10 seconds. With half the shit that gets in. I got a list. Here's the order of my list that it's in. It goes Reggie, Jay-Z, Tupac, and Biggie, Andre from out. And new motion. Okay. Sides. And go. You people got a fucking problem with me. You hate it, but you know respect you got. Give me the press. Make a nice and smooth motion. Consistent. Consistent. That's better. Stay low. 5 seconds. And switch. And go. To the sides. Don't let it come back. As soon as you go in, go back out. Like a fly. Faster. Make it nice and smooth, Chris. 5 seconds. And go. Ten seconds. I would rather sit back and find some rappers. So this is like a full-blown attack. I'm launching at him. The track is on some battle and raps and want some static. Cause I don't really think it's the fact that I'm slim matters. I'm black and platinum status. It's whack if I'm not the baddest. Here we go. That's better, Chris. That's better. Nice and wide. Get him nice and wide. Bend at the knees. Stay low. Okay, switch. Last motion. Okay, bilateral now. All the way up, all the way down. Exactly. Ten seconds. And switch. And go. 10 seconds. Okay guys, last round, here we go. Make it good. Water break coming right up. Just take strength and endurance to do it for this duration. And switch. Last time, Chris. Make it a good one. Go. So I collapse on spilling these raps as long as you feel them to the day that I drop. You'll never say that I'm not killing them. Cause when I am not, then I'ma stop pinning them. And I am not hip hop, and I'm just not Eminem. Subliminal thoughts when I'ma stop spinning them. 5 seconds. 3, 2, 1. Time. Good work. Alright, it's very important since it's a little heated out here today that our athletes stay hydrated the entire time. So at any point my athletes need water, they get water. Great warm up, guys. Now it's time for the plyometrics component of today's workout, where we'll be activating the stretch shortening cycle to improve our lower body explosiveness. Okay, our warm-up has concluded. Now it's time for our lower body plyometrics. We're gonna start here. Dave is going to be the demonstrator. We're gonna put him through the workout. We're gonna start with turtle jumps. Then we're gonna get to death jumps. Next, we'll do some concentric box jumps. Then we're gonna do single leg jumps with the TRX. Next, we'll do pike jumps. And then ski box jumps. Then we'll conclude, and we'll get into our agility section of our workout. Okay, here we're going to do the turtle hops. What Dave is going to do, he's going to start in start position, in athletic position, feet hip width apart. He's going to gather himself, jump into each gap. He'll do a total of 5. He'll do a work 1-5 ratio, so 1 second for every 5 seconds rest. So if he does it for 5 seconds, you get 25 seconds rest. Okay, here we go. He'll be doing a total of 4 sets.
I'll send you a test. See if you eventually want to go more than one of this.
Oh yeah, obviously later on, but honored. I don't want to go too quickly.
Since that took 5 seconds, we'll do a 25 second rest, and do it 3 more times. Now what Dave's going to do, he's going to be simulating being on a mount, okay? What he will be doing with his right foot to start, gathering himself and leaping up from the Bosu ball. He'll do 5 of those, he'll come back, do it again, and then he'll switch sides. Do it from his left. Again, this is a unilateral explosion required for his position. Okay, Dave, anytime you're ready, let's get started. One. Two. Good. Perfect. Notice how he's landing on his opposite foot. A lot of gluteal power required. A lot of stabilization needed. Good. And one more. Okay. And Dave will do this a total of 4 sets after his rest. Okay, now that Dave has performed his hurdle hops and warmed up his legs a little bit more, we're gonna do death jumps. Dave will be hopping off of the bench, landing, and explosively jumping up to the box in front of him. He's gonna land on that box,
step off that box. Once he steps off, he's gonna take a 5 to 10 second rest. He's gonna jump up onto the bench again. He's gonna do that 4 more times for a total of 5 times. He's gonna do a 1 to 10 work to rest ratio. So once he's completed his 5 jumps, he will rest 10 seconds to every 1 second that he spent jumping. Here we go. Jump explosively. As high as you can. 2 more. And 1 more.
Now that Dave's done his death jumps, now we're gonna do what I call concentric box jumps. What Dave experiences a lot as a baseball player, and he's always in his low crouch stance. He has to jump from the stance to get moving. Now, what this exercise will look like, he's gonna roll off of his legs using mainly his gastric nemius, soleus muscles, hopping over the bench. He's gonna land, gather himself up onto the box. He's gonna step off the box. Just as the depth jumps, rest 5-10 seconds. Is done his first set. His following 3 sets, he's going to be done holding a medicine ball. The motion does not change. We're just adding a little bit of resistance to make it a little bit more difficult for him. Hold it where it's comfortable. Anytime you're ready. 1 2 3 2 more.
One more.
High as you can. Dave's done his hurdle hops, his depth jumps, and his concentric box jumps. We're going to get into single leg jump squats. Okay, this is a unilateral movement. The reason we're doing this one, specifically for Dave and Chris, they're both pitchers. Okay? Pitchers require very strong, explosive movement off of their right plant leg when they're on the mat. Okay. As they lift, they need to have a strong motion coming across. It all starts in here to get that total body explosion to throw the ball. So since this is Chris's and Dave's first time doing single leg jump squats, we're going to incorporate the TRX. It will help with balance, stability when they do it. Now, how it'll look. Okay. Just like a normal squat, the knee does not cross the toe. Athlete will go down, jump up. Like so, 5 times. Switch legs. And again, a 1-to-10 work to rest ratio.
One, two. As soon as you land, hop right back up. One, two, good control, three, four, five, good, and rest. Now Dave will be getting into pike jumps. This is a movement Dave has done in the past. He's been improving week by week. Now he's gonna do another five sets. He's gonna jump, pike, gather himself again, jump up, and pike. In this motion, Dave is not gonna need to jump the moment he lands. I would rather him control and have balance first. We'll progress week by week as we go. Okay, Dave, whenever you're ready. One, two, three, four, five. Perfect. Very good.
Metric movements we'll do. He's going to do lateral ski box jumps. How this motion is going to work, he'll start in one box, jump down, gather himself, up. So he'll do it as soon as he lands, he's going to hop. Okay, Dave's going to do 10 lands, so it'll be essentially 5 on each side, then he'll take his rest.
Okay, Dave, anytime you're ready. One, two, three. Keep your feet together. Feet together. Good. Now that we are through our plyometric component, it's time for our agility and quickness component of today's session. Athletes will start out in the star drill, move on to the four corners drill, then the lateral agility hurdles, followed by the agility ladder, where they'll do the icky shuffle, in-outs, and crossovers.
Now what Chris is going to do here, call the star drill. He's going to start off, you want to start there, Chris? He's going to start off at the start point. Now, lateral agility is very important for a sport. What he'll be doing is from his start point, almost as if he's leading off. When I say go, he's gonna sprint, he's gonna touch his cone, sprint back, sprint, touch the next cone, sprint back, so on and so forth until he's done all of his cones. That'll be one set. He's gonna be doing 3 sets of this. And Dave is gonna have his turn and he's gonna do 3 sets as well. So on the count of 3, Chris, 3, 2, 1, go. And last one, and back, and that's one. Now Dave will go, then Chris will go, Dave will go, total 3 times each. Here we have the four corners drill. This is gonna test lateral movement, sprint speed, and back pedal. I'll slow-mo the first one, then Dave's gonna hop in, and he'll do his first set. So, to start, I'm gonna sprint to the cone, then I'm gonna shuffle to the other cone, back pedal, and shuffle the opposite way. I'm gonna stay outside of the cones each time, so slowly I'll demonstrate. You sprint, set, set, away, touch, touch. That's one. Now Dave is gonna do his set. On the count of 3, 2, 1, and go. Back pedal, stay low. And that's one. Now the athletes are going to be working on their lateral quickness using these agility hurdles. Chris will demonstrate his first set here. He's going to be starting. He's going to be jumping into each gap, exploding up to the next, all the way to the end. When he gets to the end, he'll be coming all the way back. Ready, Chris? Go.
Get ready to bounce.
And back. And that's one set. Now Dave will take his turn. Okay, now the athletes will be doing speed ladder drills. Since this is a 15-foot ladder, they're gonna be going there and back, and that'll count as their one set. They'll be doing each motion four times. Dave will just show his first set of the icky shuffle motion. Whenever you're ready, Dave. And back. Good feet, good feet. Okay, now exercise number two for the agility ladder. Chris will be showing his first set of the in-out pattern. Okay, whenever you're ready, Chris. And go. And back. Good work. Okay, now Dave will do exercise number three for the day of the agility ladder. This will be the crossover. Anytime you're ready, Dave. And back. Great, and now Chris will go his turn. Now that we've completed the agility and quickness section, we are going to get into some skill development. We'll be doing med ball pickups with a side toss, a balance point drill, and a weighted ball deceleration drill. I'll get Chris to explain a little bit of this as we go. As you can see here, Dave is tossing the ball to Chris. He's gathering himself into a squat position, picking the ball up, twisting, rotating, and explosively passing the ball forward. He'll do this five times on each side, and then they'll switch. Frame it. All right, something I like to do with my athletes when I train them, I like them to know exactly what's going on in their body, why they're doing each exercise they're doing for the sport that they're playing, rather than just putting them through drills, end of the workout, onto the next workout. Chris here is going to demonstrate exactly what we've taught. So whenever you're ready, Chris, tell me why you're doing this drill.
Yeah, for this drill, we're working on, it's called the balance point drill. And as a pitcher, it's very, very important to our pitcher mechanics every time you throw the ball. So the goal of this drill, I'm going to get into my balance position. I'm going to hold it there, touch the floor with the medicine ball, and come back into my balance position. So I'm going to get into that, put my one leg, balance position here, hold it, touch the ground with the ball, bring it back up, and I'm going to get back into my balance position here. I'm going to do that five times.
What essentially Chris is doing is a single leg deadlift. However, it translates into baseball directly. And this is why we do our drill. So again, this will be the last baseball specific drill that we're going to do today. Again, Chris is going to explain what we've learned in the last few weeks of practice. Okay, Chris, so what will you be doing here?
This drill, we're just working on extension. When you're pitching the ball, we're going to work on getting out in front and making sure that I'm releasing the ball as further away from my body as possible. Also, by holding onto the ball instead of throwing it, it's also going to be working the deceleration muscles on my shoulder as well.
Perfect.
So, do a couple of those.
Good. And how many are you going to be doing?
I'm going to do 5 of these.
Perfect. And Dave is standing here as a target. Good. Okay. Now that our athletes have had some active recovery through their skill development component, we're going to get into the sprint training component of today's session. Okay, now Chris and Dave are going to do, we're going to be doing shoot sprints. Okay, this is the sprinting section, the final section before our cool down. Now, they have a chute attached around their waistline. At the start, we'll be doing 30 meter chutes, okay? This will resemble going from home to first. Now, Chris is gonna do it this direction, then Dave will do it the opposite direction, okay? After they do that 5 times, they're gonna do 60 meter sprints. This will be done without the chute. Once they're done, there's 60 meter sprints 5 times. They'll be doing 90 meter sprints. Okay? The 90 meter sprints will be done the first 30 with a chute. At 30 meters, they're gonna unclip the chute and continue on. Okay, now 60 meter sprints on the count of 3, 2, 1, go. Tag off and go. I'm gonna drive all night through the red lights flying over the hill to the county line. Okay, now Chris is gonna do his 90 meter sprint. He's going to unclip the parachute at 30 meters and continue for the next 60 under his own power. On the count of 3, 2, 1, go! What Dave is going to demonstrate here, as he stands, he's going to run to his 10 meter distance, back to start, to the 20 meter distance, back to start. That's one rep. Gonna tag Chris in, Chris is gonna do his. Okay? You're gonna do this a total of 4 times.
Count
of
3, 2, 1,
go. And back, fast as you can, fast as you can. And go. Touch it. Jump back to me anytime. Jump back to me anytime. Sprint it all the way, Chris. Jump back to me anytime. That concludes our preseason plyometric speed and quickness workout for today. Now the athletes will be doing a 5 to 10 minute cooldown walk on the track and then going into a stretching component to finish things off. Thank you for watching.